Hello. Yes, this is working. Oh. Let's see.
Did you bring some fish?
Okay, let's see. This should be working a little bit better.
Let's get moving!
Reporting for duty.
Job done.
Okay, seems like we're getting the call from Jason. Hey. Hey, Jason.
Hey, how's are you?
Good, how are you?
Not too bad.
All right, I'm still setting things up. People should be starting to connect, but we're going to be 1 or 2 minutes late. Fashionably late, anyway.
Okay.
Give me a few minutes. I'm going to put your head, because we won't have their head this time, so I'll put yours and mine.
Sounds good to me.
did I send you the link to the actual streaming? There you go.
Yeah, I saw it.
Okay, cool.
Is there a delay on that at all?
There is like 5 seconds of delay, 10 seconds maybe.
Okay.
You know what? We did that last time. I could still do it. It's like, it's not a lot of memory for me. It's like 300 megs of RAM. But I thought, you know, maybe if people have questions, we can take questions at the end. That's going to be easier.
Yeah. Very cool.
Yeah. Well, we'll see if people show up. I announced it a little bit late. This is a little bit, I wouldn't say unexpected, but really, like, I didn't think I was going to stream tonight.
Yeah, I think most people probably have other things to do at 9 p.m. on a Saturday, but...
Yeah, surprisingly, so Saturday is the lowest.
You and I clearly don't, so...
Sad, but true. All right, let's see if I can do this here. Oh my god, you're taking the whole screen, but... Oh, there you go. All right. Can you start a new game? Just to make sure that everything lines up with the UI.
We'll just go. It's the innkeeper.
Yeah, that works.
Or how many people can spectate in Hearthstone? Can we both spectate the guy?
So the way it works, you can spectate both sides, and
okay,
you
so
see
you'll spectate
cards.
One, I'll spectate the other.
No. One client can actually spectate both sides.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's kind of cool.
Nice.
Okay.
I didn't know if I would be watching the stream or if I'd be watching my client.
Yep. Ready for action. Would you mind trying to switch to Skype instead?
Sure, that's cool.
Yeah, because my four CPUs are like 100% right now. I'm kind of freaking
no problem.
Out. I'll just call. Well, I'll give you my Skype name.
Perfect.
All right. Sorry about that. Okay, so yeah, like I said, we're gonna have like a 5 minutes delay that will not appear at all on the final video because, well, I'm gonna cut all of that. So it's gonna take 2 seconds to install Skype, surprisingly. But we're still 5 minutes ahead of our schedule, so it's all good. Oh, look at that. Oh, that's much better. Okay. Oh man, I need to receive a sign. Added me. So I got the. Okay, so Track can't make it. Track was the one. I've got Dave's classes. What the hell? Why is he on offline? Aww. Okay, he went offline. All right, let's. Okay. Surprisingly, it's gonna be easier.
No.
Yeah, that works. Alright, let's try Skype, just in case it takes less. Stuff of working in audio video. Yeah, it seems like he's offline. Sorry. Oh, yeah, I know. Okay, so he can, looks like things are starting to get back to normal. Keeps failing on Skype. So let's try another one. So some issues with Hangout. I'm the last on the track. So basically, one thing that we're trying to do right now, just to keep you in the loop, is we're trying to use Skype instead of Hangouts for communicating because, well, turns out that Hangouts still has the same problem as last time, which was like a little bit of audio delay and problems. So maybe Skype is better. Also, I would suspect Skype to take less of my bandwidth, of my CPU. So, if you hang on. Anyway, we're still waiting for the the players are there. Okay, just give a second. All right, let me just take a note here. Oh, this is so awkward. Okay. Oh, that's gonna be easy. That's gonna be super easy. All right. Oh boy. Okay, everyone. Okay, hello everyone, this is Hans again, Hansel, streaming again for the match between Target and Ectopic, again. Basically, this is the loser bracket, so these players have at least lost one game and at most lost one game, except tonight there's gonna be one winner between them again, and there's gonna be a guy that's dropping out. The winner is gonna go to the finals of the loser brackets, and then the finals of the loser bracket is gonna go against the winner of the winner. Oh my god, this is so complex sometimes. So this is the loser brackets. The loser of this game is gonna get bumped out of the tournament altogether, and the winner of this game is gonna go against the loser of the final of the winner bracket. Something like that. So tomorrow. Okay, so I'm gonna start the stream anyway. Tomorrow we have the
Luther versus Dana.
You asked for it.
I will.
Tomorrow
fight
we
with
have
honor.
The finals of the winners bracket. A really great match that I recommend everyone to see. This is going to be really great. So tonight we have Dave and Alex, the same two players as the last cast that I did with Track. Track couldn't make it tonight. I'm sorry about that. Playing tonight. So they are playing tonight on Mage, Paladin, and Warlock for both of them. So both of them decided to go with the same classes again. Not again, but the same classes as the other one, which means that it's going to be a really great best of five. I can't wait to see. I want a mirror matchup. I really want a mirror matchup. So anyway, Night Juggler into Mad Scientist here. If he can't figure out that's a noble sacrifice, I mean, there's nothing I can say. there you go. So this seems to be a... yeah, this is definitely a freeze mage against a secret paladin, which is really great because if the paladin can get the advantage really early on, he can still win, but this is an uphill battle for him. The mage paladin should have the upper hand as soon as he can pull like some doomsayer shit out against. That being said, that's a great card, even if it's a one turn late. Muster for Battle is such a good value right now with Keeper of Ill Demand next turn. Consecration is basically a dead card. So he decides to go for the quick 2 damage, and it's of course it's an ice barrier. Meaning that he gets like another turn of rest against the paladin. So he picks up a Forgotten Torch. It seems like this is the freeze mage with a Forgotten, the 2 Forgotten Torch, and maybe a single Arcane Intellect variant, which I tried a lot on ladder in the last couple of days, and an Explosive Sheep. I saw that. But I've never really played that because I think it's a little bit too slow and a little bit too expensive compared to like other things like a Pyroblast. But we'll see. It's definitely going to be useful for him against the Secret Paladin. Is he going to explode that right now? Oh, okay. Yeah, that makes more sense. Yeah, the Explosive Sheep is a little bit of a surprise for Dave. I think he wasn't really expecting that. Actually, he probably has a good idea right now that it's a Freeze Mage, and he knows that he's on the counter. Let's see how he reacts to everything. Okay. Well, he popped the Explosive Sheep a little bit earlier. He must have been afraid that he had something, that Alex had something up his sleeve. Obviously, he did not. I kind of like this interface because you can see the cards of both sides. But like the fact that you can't really see what's being drawn and all that is a little bit annoying. By the way, everyone who listens right now, I'm checking the chat of this stream, and you can ask your questions here. Don't be afraid to ask your questions here. Don't be afraid. I'll ask the questions on stream. I'll talk to the winner after that. I really want to talk to the winner. I'm not going to do the same mistake as I did last time, which is... So it seems like Jason is back online. He's trying to call me on Hangouts. Let's see how that goes. Alright. None of your business. So the Secret Paladin turn 6, the Mysterious Challenger. Of course, there is no answer for that right now except Frost Noling and Doomsayer. Okay, so we lost Jason, who was supposed to be co-casting with me, but unfortunately he had some problems with his internet before, so we're... you think he's on the call? What? Oh, hey!
Hey, I think we did it.
Yes, we did.
Woohoo!
All right, cut your camera. Right. It's sucking my CPU, please.
You got it.
All right. Camera off. Oh, there you go. Oh, that's much better. I have like a couple cycles per second now. So, are you spectating the game?
I am watching it on your stream.
Okay. So right now it's Secret Paladin against like Dave's Secret Paladin against Alex's Freeze Mage. It seems that the Doomseer will go through.
Reporting for duty.
That poor token is gonna die as it is. And we have redemption for the Keeper of the Man. That's not gonna last long.
at least that Shredder is gonna bring something out though.
Yeah, the Shredder popped a Undercity. Yes, Undercity Valiant, which is a 3-2 basically.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. So there's not a lot of choice for Golden Torch. Of course, the Keeper of the Man. He knows that it's Noble Sacrifice. Oh, he's Flame Striking. Okay. I guess it was a good turn for that, but there is like some surprise with Master for Battle and a Shield on your butt.
Yeah. So,
yeah. And an
Is Alex the Freeze Mage?
Yes. Dave is target 1138 and Alex very specific.
Looking at Alex's hand right now, I don't see any duplicates. Do we know if he's got Reno in his deck somewhere?
No, he doesn't.
Okay.
I saw duplicates. There were a duplicate of. Actually, you might be right.
You might. Do you have a deck list? Somewhere?
No, I just have the classes. So both of them are gonna play Paladin, Mage, and Warlock.
Oh, okay.
So we'll see. We'll see who plays those classes better. Oh, here's a turn. So
for the benefit of the viewers, not at all because I don't know the answer to this question. Is this a conquest format? Is that what we're doing here?
Yes, yes. This is totally conquest. Both the winner has to win with all three classes. Once he wins with one, he cannot reuse it again. But of course, the loser has to reuse the classes he lost with. For those who don't know the conquest format. So we got Tyrion on the board, which is really good for the weapon mostly, but at this point, honestly, like I've played that matchup on ladder a lot in the last 2 months. I bring life. This is really unfair for
pull your hair out every time.
yeah
no, I'm personally not a big fan of going against freeze mages, but I don't have the patience for it.
Well, yeah, playing freeze mages definitely develop some patience. So the Alexstrasza came in, of course. Dave is at 15 HP, looking at Alex's hand. He's one freeze bolt away from killing him, so he's betting on the fact that he's gonna draw something, and also on the fact that Dave doesn't have a card in hand. So Arcane Intellect, two more chances of picking up fatal damage. Reno, oh, that's you're right.
Yeah.
You are right. It is the Reno Jackson variant.
Yeah, just in case you thought you might beat the freezer.
And the fun fact is that he has duplicate Acolyte of Pain. So
yeah, you're right there.
I wonder if he has other acolytes.
I wonder.
Yeah.
Not acolytes, duplicates. Sorry.
Yeah, and I know that.
Sorry.
Blizzard has stated, you know, hey, we'd love to put that little yellow border around Reno when he's going to activate, but we don't have the tech to do that. So
yeah,
as us spectators who don't know this guy's list, you know, we have no idea if this Reno is going to be helpful at all or not.
Yep.
But I'm sure he knows exactly whether or not it's going to take effect.
Yep. Thalnas. So that's seven. If he puts the Thalnas, oh, he's going to Iceman. So I guess he does have some duplicate in his deck, since he's probably afraid of being at zero right now.
Yeah.
Yep, that's a good Divine Favor. Five cards for 2-3 mana.
Yeah, that's a real good one.
Yep. What are you playing here? Mysterious Challenger for having the buddy on the board, I guess?
Yeah,
I'd say so. Yeah, the secrets aren't going to do anything, really.
No. I mean, you can go for the sledge bolt or just for the stickiness and that, you know, if it gets taken down, you still get something else, but...
Yep.
Anything, but, you know, I agree with the mysterious challengers for the damage in that 6-6.
Yeah, I mean, if this goes to fatigue, the paladin is just gonna lose right
off. Must move quickly!
Yeah. And seems Ooh, like Dave agrees with me. One mini secret, which is advance. So he does have 7 minions on the board, so even if the Acolyte of Pain attack, the Noble Sacrifice will not trigger. That's a Blizzard though. He could, I hope he doesn't think about using that.
Yeah, that's a good draw for him.
Yes.
7 minions on the board. Big nice AoE spell.
Yep.
Kills more than half of them.
Cone of Cold.
He's got a Doomsayer too.
Yeah. So he had double Doomsayers at least.
Yeah.
I don't know
double
what...
Double Acolytes.
Yeah, I don't know if he has double Forgotten or double Fireball.
One of the details that is, or such a small detail that impresses me with the pros, and you know, these guys are, I'm assuming, pretty good based on how far they are along the tournament, is just the placement of minions. I mean, like, it's fairly straightforward here. He's got a bunch of 6/6s and 1/1s, and you know,
yeah,
cold.
Can't do anything.
Yeah.
So we got. Okay, so he's gonna bring him to. He's 8 cards from fatigue. I mean, one good way to pop an ice block is to bring the other person to fatigue just before you apply the last damage. But what he doesn't know is that there is a real Jackson in his hand.
Yeah.
And that will change everything. That will be.
Although what we don't know is whether the Reno Jackson is gonna kick in or not.
Well, yeah, but at 7
it's pretty
cards,
far along in the game.
Exactly. I think there is a good chance it will, but you never know.
Yep. I was reading an article earlier today actually saying that it was about like how to counter freeze mages. They said that secrets don't activate on your own turn.
Yes.
I did not know that. That is news to me.
Yeah, that's he picked up the Roaring Torch and the game is gonna go to Alex. But yes, secret like Ice Block will not pop on your own turn.
Yeah, I didn't know that. That's interesting. It's probably really difficult to take advantage of that.
That's, yeah, and that's the Curse of Rafam is actually a good card against Freeze Mage, sorry.
Remind me of what that spell does. You get that from playing Rafam, I assume.
Yeah, you get that from playing Warlock, I think, in the new expansion, League of Explorer. Mm-hmm. And what it does is basically it puts a card in your hand that costs 2 mana, and as long as you have that card, at the start of your turn you take 2 damage. So you can play it for 2 mana, but the first turn you're gonna take like 2 damage. So the tactic would be to bring the fridge mage to to 2 HP, give him a Curse of Rafam, and the ice block will not survive. The ice block will not.
Okay. Interesting.
So yeah, Blizzard is introducing mechanics like that, which I really like myself.
Sorry. Yeah, I think it's interesting anytime that they make a new expansion or they make a new adventure. It's kind of like, okay, what do we want to be good now?
Yes, and I hope they take a break from
you asked for it
from new mechanics and start to revisit like mechanics that are already existing, like Inspire and Joust. I think there is a lot to do there that could be improved. So
and,
this seems to be a Freeze Mage against. I'm not sure what kind of Warlock this is.
Yeah, we got there. Yeah, not too obvious right now. I would guess Handlock, but Or Arena Lock's the new hotness these days, isn't it?
It is. And he kept Lothub, so he probably knows that this is a freeze mage, or at least he has a good idea of it.
We have a good idea of seeing Ice Barrier there.
Yes, I mean, Ice Barrier, Doomsayer, it's pretty much a given.
I'll show them all. I was gonna say I was a little disappointed there was a few times with a new expansion, new adventures where it sounded like Blizzard was really buffing a certain element that I was excited for. So I know with Black Rock Mountain, I was like, oh man, I'm gonna make a dragon deck. This is gonna be so cool. And just the Black Rock Mountain cards really weren't that great for the most part.
Alright, so people are asking, please, two Ice Barriers. Okay, so sorry, I don't have to. What's the score at, Hans? So right now, Ectepic won the first game, and it's 1-0. Ectepic won with the Freeze Mage.
Hans, are you able to update that graphic you have on the side there to say, 1-0 or 0-1,
yeah,
things like that?
Actually, you know what? I can do that.
That'd be cool.
Yep. Yeah. So, target 1. So, it seems like it's a pure handlock, seeing Ancient Watcher and Molten Giants, which really, like, Molten Giant, you wouldn't expect that in a tournament. In my opinion, it's a bad card because people know. Maybe it's still. Oh, sorry.
What to do?
There's two Zombie Chow, so I doubt that it might not be a Reno lock.
Oh, that's true. Although a lot of Reno decks have a couple duplicates, they're like, okay, I'll have these four duplicates, and I just need to remember, did I draw these four cards? Yes, cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I remember Molten was one of the first like rare cards I had, and so I put it in every deck when I first started playing, and I was like, yeah, this really isn't helpful very often, but when you're Warlock and you're just taking damage a bunch of times and you have a bunch of things like what's his name? The guy who gives taunt to the two people on the other side of you.
Sun Fury Protector or Defender of Argus.
There you go, Defender of Argus, what I was thinking of, but play as a zero mana Molten Giant and then Defender of Argus, that's a pretty big change in the game state, yeah.
Oh, can I put myself offline in the... I don't think I can, because I have a friend who just contacted me. Anyway, doesn't matter. I just told him to go away. So we got the second Ice Barrier. This is going to be a long uphill battle for the Warlock. And I'm sorry, I realized like Jay told me that my names were inverted, so now Ectepic 1, Target 0, they're on the proper sides of this. And you know what, I think I'm gonna remove my face.
But it's such a handsome face.
I know, I'm really shy.
Sorry, viewers.
Yep, there you go. It's gonna be easier for everybody.
Pain, speak to me. What demons does he have? Is this Void Collar gonna bring out?
So there is.
No, everything's upside down. And
there is another Void Collar, definitely.
That's fun.
Is he a 10 card now? Yes, he's at 10 card, so he has to play something. That's pretty much it for that. Void Collar, there's no other demon. Yeah, and it feels for Alex, this would be a good Frostnova on Doomsayer.
Yeah, I agree.
In the next turn. He has two of, he has double combo, so you can't afford to lose one like that.
Yeah. Those Ancient Watchers, man, when they get played, you're like, ah, that's not a problem. And then they get a taunt or they get a silence, all of a sudden it's like, oh.
Yeah, this is a really good value card when you have the tools for it. You have to check for it, though.
Warlock.
Yeah.
So you just pop that any other any old deck, and it's like, okay, here's a card, I guess.
So, yeah, Dave missed a, not Dave, Alex missed a really good occasion to make Dave overdraw one card.
Mm.
He's at 9 right now. If he popped both the Acolyte and the Loot Order, he would have overdrawn the whatever card is next.
Yeah. That's always fun to do.
Yeah.
I mean, like, if you don't get through your deck, then it doesn't make too much of a difference, you know? Because it's like, oh, the card I discarded, but I didn't even get them on my deck, so those cards were also essentially discarded. But you just feel real smart for making your play, your opponent do it, and being the person who has too many cards, you just feel dumb, and then you might tilt. Or...
Yeah, it's not about the card, it's about sending a message, you know? Sorry, as you can hear, I'm still a little bit sick. Oh, here's a Thorazine. Yeah, I'm not gonna cast the game tomorrow. You will host it, so.
Yeah. So the Jason loser Mooney. Of the game tomorrow will be playing the winner of this match. Is that accurate?
So the winner of the game tomorrow is gonna play against the winner of the next game in the losing brackets.
Okay.
So these two are going. The winner of this matchup is going to go against Emyth, I think is the name of the other person.
Okay.
And Emyth is.
So many possibilities.
And the winner of the winner bracket tomorrow, that you, Jason Mooney, will host with the Track Lord.
Yeah.
We'll play against the winner of that game. So Dr. Boom is what? Okay. Alright, that's
Whoa. I just got up to what you see and like, why would
I don't know. But that's
I
a really
he just wants the damage out of the boom bots?
I guess so. That's a really good turn to Thorazine at this point. But yeah, it's that was weird for me.
Yeah. Maybe he just thought he wouldn't have a better time to play it.
Maybe, yeah.
This is too slow for me to play any other time, so...
I mean, that's a really valid concern, so yes. Jiraxxus on board, that's definitely not a card you want to play on itself against a freeze mage. I mean, it's an automatic Alexstrasza, so...
Well, he's at 16 health. I mean, at the moment, he's at 16 health, but...
Yeah,
he's of course, he can heal. He's got a... I see the antique heal bot in there.
Yeah, he's in a really bad spot, but he can get out of there. The problem is that... He's within the spot of, like, with the Emperor Thorazine. One Frostboat and one Iceland and one Fireball can kill him, so...
I see
that's really the spot where you don't want to be. Around, like, below 20 HP. And yes, that was a really good Lothab.
Yeah. Yep. Like, wow. This, both these players are just so perfect right now, right? That's an amazing time to Thorazine just... He has so many cards and a bunch of pieces of, you know, combo for lethal, and then... Oh, well, not this turn, at least.
Yeah, no, definitely not. But he knows that the end is near, so...
Yeah.
I don't know what he's looking for. I don't know if he runs Reno Jackson. I don't know if it's a Reno. There's too many duplicates, in my opinion, but I could be wrong.
I agree. I've seen a bunch of duplicates as well. But, yeah, you never know.
Oh, Neo Almost just told me that he had 10 cards, so Alex had 10 cards when he played Dr. Boom, and that's probably
good. Good call there. Yeah, it's like, I gotta get rid of something.
Yep, here comes the pyroblast, so.
I mean, as much as I hate getting power blasted, it's still kind of fun.
That's the, yeah.
All of my mana and do so much damage to your face.
And it's such a huge graphic going through the
yeah.
screen. It's like bigger than your character.
Yeah.
I agree. That there's a feeling to pyroblasting.
Yeah.
You require my assistance.
So Alex should know by now that the end is near. But let's see if he has something up his sleeve to help him.
Aha!
He's gonna get him. So many fireballs. I guess just two, but.
Yeah, he can do 18 plus 10, like 28. Plus, still has like the combo Doomsayer first Nova. Plus, a couple of Fire Blast.
Yeah, I, it's hard to imagine any way that for Alex to turn this around now.
Mm-hmm.
We'll see what he has planned.
So he just picked up what, a Twilight Drake? Yeah, that's not gonna do it. Oh, and he's gonna go. He's gonna freeze Tiresias.
Does that unfreeze you?
Yes.
Nice.
You're not the same character anymore, but.
Yeah, makes sense.
Yeah, unfortunately, that doesn't solve anything. he gained one turn by doing that, so it's something. It's just like it's not gonna be enough.
So how much damage could he do this turn if he wanted? He could do two fireballs.
Yeah, plus the fire blast.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, it's just it's gonna be 13 damage, and yeah, let's see what happens. What was that Elfire? Yeah, so that's not gonna do anything.
And the ping.
Yeah. I would presume he add like Malagus, which not Malagus, but. What's the demon that makes you invincible? Oh my god.
Oh yeah, Mal'Ganis.
Mal'Ganis, I don't know why.
Yeah, yeah. I was saying, Malagos would be really fun to see.
There is a Maragos freeze mage that I want to try.
Okay.
Probably. Looks really fun. But that is not it.
Yeah. That Infernal Golden.
Yep.
I've seen Malagos in a rogue deck that looks like a lot of fun, but it's... Also looks really frustrating to play against because you have no idea that you're going against a Malagos Rogue deck until the last turn. You play that and you play a bunch of free spells from Thursand.
And here's the finisher, the Pyroblast.
Pyroblast for two damage.
Yep, and the two well played.
Yeah.
Which was one of our comments. The last time these two played together, we were like, there's not enough BM. These guys can BM infinitely later. It's not like the 5 seconds timer that you see on ladder.
Yeah.
When you play with friends, you can BM as much as you want. I want to see Jarexus say like Oblivion over and over and over again.
Yeah.
Come on, guys, you can do that. And yes, two freeze mage, two wins for the freeze mage. I'll update the score. But yeah, basically so far, the best class is Freeze Mage.
That brings us to 1-1. And that's one of the reasons I really like this format is, and I know I watched a tournament maybe a month or so ago where it was, once you lose with the class, you can't use that class anymore. So kind of the opposite of Conquest.
Yes.
And so there are a lot of games where the winner would go 5-0 with his best deck. And that's just much less interesting to me to watch the same deck
exactly.
over and over and over.
And that was the official format for Blizzard's tournament last year, I think. 2014, sorry, not last year.
Okay.
Last year. So, but they switch away for that particular reason, I think.
Yeah. I mean, it's kind of cool, but you're like, wow, this guy went 5-0. That deck must be so good. Like, there's that element to it, but it's just it's more fun to see the different classes because you get a whole bunch of different set of cards. So.
Yep.
It's just fun. So
these guys are playing. Oh, okay. So there is a faceless manipulator. So it's the combo warlock against the Henlock that we just saw. So we'll see how that one goes.
I'm not familiar with this deck archetype. What is the do you face with manipulator on a buffed up Molten Giant or something?
So you normally do like Leroy Jenkins. The combo is like Leroy Jenkins and two power overwhelming into like faceless manipulator. You have the mana at 10 mana, and that does 24 damage. That does, sorry, 28 damage.
Oh my god!
Yeah. So you can. It's the one turn kill. If it's pulled off properly, that is. Sometimes it's, you know.
And
it's,
you need like, a Therasan, I think, to get that.
Actually, you can do it without Therasan.
Okay.
But of course, everything is always better with Therasan. Sorry, what were you saying?
Well, I didn't know how much Leroy cost off the top of my head. Do you need Therasan?
Six mana, I think. It's a 6/2 for six mana.
So you do need something to reduce the cost then.
Actually I think you're right. Leroy Jenkins. Let's see.
What's that?
It's five mana. So you think you need at least one turn of Thorison on something, okay. Yes.
Yeah.
One version that I've seen is replacing Leroy Jenkins with what's the card that costs like four that gives your opponent a mana crystal?
Mana crystal, and you get the 4/2. It's like something golem, I think, right?
Let me Google that for you.
Yeah. I'm sure chat's blowing up at us right now. Like, it's this
Arcane Golem. Actually,
Arcane Golem. Thank you, Neo Almost.
There you go, Neo Almost. Yeah, Arcane Golem, 3 mana. I was faster than you by 2 seconds. All right.
I think this tells us that Neo Almost is a face hunter. So, like, oh, you know the name of that card off the top here. So both of our combatants in this match are running Warlock, Paladin, and Mage. Are those just generally perceived as the three strongest classes right now? Do you know?
Actually, no. I think we saw some druids. The last time there was a druid.
I was surprised none of them were playing.
Yeah, the last time these two played, one of them played. What did I just say? Priest.
Druid?
Priest. There was a dragon priest.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that was kind of fun. Sorry, Almost. Sorry, I still love you. Oh my god, with the can you see the crown over my name for saying that it's the owner? When I put the smiley under it, it looks like the smiley is the king.
King smiley, I like it.
So, there's not much going on for Ectopic right now. He's just outside of the sweet spot you want to be for the Molten Giants to come in. But if he does nothing on the board, he's gonna be really out of hand. He does have a Sunfury Protector for next turn if he like decides to go Lothem, for example. But that might not be enough. That might be too little, too late. There's absolutely nothing in his hand that can turn around the game so much. Oh, okay. So he decides to go Sunfury Protector right now on the Argent Watcher.
Shields up.
And the Zombie Child, which is a good choice considering that Dave has only 27 HP. Here's a Tart Peddler, so let's see what he's gonna, if he's gonna go for that.
There's just so many good Warlock cards. I know when I first saw that I was like, oh cool, you get a one card, whatever. But then after like seeing it in action a few times, it's like, wow, that's exactly what they needed right there.
Yeah. Oh, so these are definitely not the cards you're looking for. A power overwhelming would have been lethal, I think, at this point in the game. with Shadow Flame to get rid of the of both, but... Oh, it seems like I lost my my sound. Give me a second. Okay, can you still hear me, guys?
All right.
Okay, can you hear the game?
I wonder.
Okay. So there is a problem with my computer. Decided to go. Okay. So if I sound, if I set the output to Sunflower, I don't hear it, but you guys can hear it. So that's kind of
good. Best I can tell, they hear you, but not the game.
I'm sorry, Jason. I'll just disconnect my headphones, reconnect them into another output. Try to reconfigure everything.
You need to drop off the call? Is that what's happening?
Let's see. MIDI.
I'm on a board control right now.
Okay, can you hear me?
I can hear you, but I'm not sure if the stream can.
Yes, they can, actually. Yeah, they should be able to hear everything. And I can hear you, too. Sorry about that.
Hey, I'm glad that we got it figured out.
So he's at 4 HP. Oh, this is a Reno Jackson deck.
Yeah.
That's a good surprise.
I say, but he doesn't. He's basically at full health right now, so.
I know, but even if he like gets down to, can he get out of there? Hillbot, but he, yeah, he does have the mana for a Hillbot, so that's kind of good.
Mm-hmm. Those free mountain giants.
Yep.
No way to buff the Mountain Giant. But doesn't have enough Interaxis until next turn.
Oh, there's another one. Perfect timing. Unfortunately, that's not going to be enough with power overwhelming on whatever minion he decides to pick.
Yeah.
Or even without power overwhelming, my math was off. I thought it was Good job, guys. Well played. So target is 2-4 against 1.
One went away.
Mm-hmm.
And he's got Secret Paladin left, I believe.
Yeah, the first deck he played.
Yep.
No, wait, he has Paladin. We didn't see what kind of Paladin it was.
I thought he had a few mysterious challengers in there.
Dave, yes. I mean, Alex. I will command the light.
Oh, okay.
But it seems it's gonna be secret against secret. It's who has the most beautiful Christmas tree? Basically. Oh, and the perfect curve, exactly what you would like in a Secret Paladin. That's
1, 2, 3
incredible.
Top there.
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, I play a decent amount of Paladin, but I don't play Secret Paladin personally. Do you keep a secret in your opening hand? Because that's just one less secret that the Mysterious Challenger can pull in.
Yes, but it depends which one. Normally... And against whom, basically? Like, a Noble Sacrifice is more likely to get kept in this matchup, but Because the only way you can pull secrets is like through Mysterious Challenger, which is 6 mana. So until like at least round 5 or 6, you don't have any secret to play. But it's always good to have secrets when you play against a deck that's more like board control.
Yeah, and you got nothing else to do turn 1. Unless you got some zombie channels and another one to fish for.
Yeah, exactly. So double Millibot on the board, nothing really spectacular. Unfortunately, a Noble Sacrifice was not played last turn, so the Knife Juggler is... Yeah, exactly. So, yeah.
So doing some playing the Knife Juggler to get the Divine Shield, or... I just caught up with you.
Are you spectating or are you on the stream?
I'm on the stream.
Oh, okay. So yeah, right now Alex is in a really good position.
Reporting for duty.
Dave is a little bit behind, but that's probably gonna change over the next few turn. Next one is gonna be a strong one for him with Keeper of Old Man. Meanwhile, Alex has a few choices here. He's gonna go for the Keeper of Old Man.
None may steal us.
He could also have Chill Dead Mini Bot number 2, but.
Yeah, I just bought League of Explorers today, and Keeper of Old Man is one of the main reasons.
Yes,
it's
a really strong card.
I really like that you can use it to kind of, you know, take the wind out of a really strong enemy minion or to buff one of your own little guys here.
Yeah.
Like you just said there. And I also love that it's a 3/4 minion. So
it can't
if you
get
do,
killed by
right,
the...
if you do it to an enemy, they can't, they're going to leave that turn.
It's a huge turn of tempo. It's an incredible card that's really versatile. A lot of people hate it in Arena.
Sure. I can see why.
Yeah, I mean,
but
in Arena...
There's lots of cards people hate in Arena, so...
Yeah, but Paladin was already really strong in Arena, and now they're just that stronger.
Yeah.
But people will always find things to complain about. That was a nice Divine Favor. That's... Oh! There is Sir Murgleton. Huh.
Oh.
Yeah, I wonder what he's thinking of switching to.
Yeah, what do you think he would look for?
Maybe he doesn't have anything to... So, Knife Juggler and Muster for Battle is probably a really good play right now. Because you can pop... Like, you can kill the mini-bot, hopefully.
Put this apple on your head.
Yeah, Knife Juggler and Muster is always a really good combo.
Yeah.
It's real lucky you might even get a... kill on the not out of it, but it's pretty unlikely.
Yeah, well, the mini bot is gonna probably go against the Knife Juggler. You don't want to keep that on the
who
on
am
the
I? None of your business.
Or attack.
I'll say if he got lucky enough with the juggles, that he might take
that's,
it out.
By the way, I just saw that's 2 secret. That's more of a tempo paladin than secret paladin. It's more mid range.
Hmm.
That's probably why he went with Murgleton. He's probably looking into like, I don't know, priest or something.
Yeah, it's priest or tank up or armor up, try to just stall out a little longer.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I mean, Secret Paladin, their whole goal is really to win on turn 6. Not literally, but
basically,
play mysterious, get the Christmas tree, and then your opponent never recovers. And if they do, you don't have a whole lot of things to keep going. So,
yep. He's testing for Noble Sacrifice. He saw that it was it. Avenge is going to be a little bit more problematic for him.
Who am I?
But,
none of your business.
Nope. Nothing in this game is anyone's business, apparently. So. that's more like a
target there to, you know, proc those secrets before playing his own Mysterious Challenger. You don't want to get his, you know.
All right, So what is going to
pick? Saving grace essentially there to be, get dropped to 1 HP immediately.
Well played.
Do you want... Yeah, I think Dave is surprised. Like, Murrogilton is a big surprise for him. I'm really curious what he's going to pick because...
Well, dagger? I bet he's not going to take the dagger.
I mean, against Paladin, it can be good. They're all 1-1s.
That's true. And, you know, you only have to use it every other turn. But at the same time, I mean, that's just every turn you take 1 damage to the face for...
Yes. Yes.
For nothing. But.
So we got... Secret Rogue.
Quickly.
Oh. Alright. I think I was I'm looking at it, I was like, well, as long as he doesn't pick the dagger, he'll be fine.
No, I think dagger was kind of the nice choice.
Yeah.
Just because he... Oh, that's perfect too. But just because he, there are so many 1-1s on the board. But yeah, Priest would have been maybe better. Did he attack with the... Okay, he's finishing his turn. Okay.
Yeah, he attacked with his face.
Yeah, that sounds about right. And here's the Competitive Spirit. That's not lethal, but that's getting really close because that's 18 damage on the board. So if he... And a lucky knife juggler with a token could actually kill Alex.
Yeah. It's so hard not to play Dr. Boom on turn 7. It just feels so good.
Yes. I mean, that it is the temple play.
Yeah.
It's definitely like up there with 99% of the time you should just Dr. Boom without even looking at it.
Right.
But he decides to go with the rift play.
Quickly.
He did the math. Let's see if he pays off for him. Nope, it doesn't. So he's 1 damage up lethal. It goes on Sir Murgleton.
Oh, that's the worst target. Because at least if it had gone off the champion, you could have traded champions and then only lost 1 damage to it.
So he goes for board control. Oh no. Okay, yeah.
There's something awesome. What just happened?
No, he didn't finish his old animation. Oh. He didn't attack with the 5-4.
Oh, that's rough.
He got roped. Yeah. So Keeper of Wilderman is not gonna do much. Tyrion. Oh, sorry. I didn't see the Tyrion. There's no brainer right there. It's just you Tyrion and you. That's it.
Yeah.
I wonder.
The problem is that Repentance is gonna pop, and that's something. That's gonna be another surprise. That's a great game. I like games where there's a lot of surprises.
Yeah.
And Secret Paladins is a deck that promotes a lot of surprise moments.
Yeah. Finley's pretty surprising too.
Yeah. Dr. Boom is going to activate the Knife Juggler for 3 knives, so that could kill the Tyrion. That could make things really awkward. Nope, 1, 2, and the Tyrion is down, but the Ashbringer...
I was going to say, he's going to get a big old sword out of that, but...
Yeah, but it's like 5 HP.
Yeah.
He has to pull out like 3 damage out of his hand, and he doesn't have it.
Yeah, I mean, I can't think of... Unless he's running, what is it? There's some spell where you hit somebody with a hammer and it does 3 damage and you draw a card.
The thing that he could have done to be lucky. Well, no, there was no way to be lucky at all. So so Dave is gonna be 3-1. Dave is gonna really win this game, win this match again. He was the winner of the last match, so I'm.
I was just about to ask who won in the winner's bracket, but it's Dave again. So.
Yep. So congratulations to him.
Yeah. Well played on both players. Those were fun games to watch.
Yep.
I'm bummed that they're done. I want to keep watching. just keep playing, you guys.
just keep going at it. Like, just rotate. Take the basic decks.
Yeah, there you go.
So, does chat has any questions for the winner? Do you have time for? All right. So let's I'm gonna add. Are you still there, Jason?
I'm still here. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. I'm gonna try to add Dave to this call. Can I add him? Yeah, I can add him. Yeah, I want to see, I want to have his reaction on the...
Hey there.
Hey, Dave. Dave.
Congratulations.
Yes. Congratulations. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. How are you?
Good. Good. We would have loved to have the webcam again, just to see your face when there was a Sir Murgleton that went into like a dagger.
I was very surprised at the Murgleton going to dagger. I did not see that coming.
Well, you had the choice between priest, hunter, and rogue.
Interesting. Yeah. I mean, I was so low after when he had that giant 9/7 on the board that it seems like hunter might have been a good choice there.
Actually, yes. Yeah. If he did,
we were saying when we were casting, I was like, "Oh, he's got two great options. Just don't pick the dagger." And then, and he did. I mean, Hans liked the dagger. I was rooting for priest or hunter.
I mean, the dagger is the only option for any kind of board control. So yeah. I guess mostly I was surprised to see Murgleton in the deck at all.
Yeah. Well, were you surprised when he played Mysterious Challenger and there were two secrets?
Yeah, there were only two secrets.
Yeah.
What was it? So what was in the rest of his deck? Did he have
mostly tempo stuff?
Yeah, I mean, he had played a few secrets, and he had some secrets in his hand as well. So
oh, I see. He just drew poorly.
Yeah. But probably should have had more secrets in the deck for a true Secret Paladin deck.
Maybe. I mean, one of the great things about Secret Paladin is that if you get the Mysterious Challenger off, you can clean your deck out of secrets and never draw them again. So,
yeah.
You know.
That is real nice.
You don't want to run too many secrets.
That's true, too.
Yeah. So we don't really have questions, but we just want to I just want to let you know that I'm still like disappointed a little bit, and I'm sure Track will share my my concern here. You did not BM clearly enough.
Look, on the Google on Google map, it seems like sportsmanship is probably a good idea.
Yeah, but BM can be a part of sportsmanship. It doesn't have to be like super bad. It just has to be fun.
People aren't tuning in here to see sportsmanship.
Sorry.
On a Saturday night, come on.
Yes. All right. Thanks, Dave. Any final word? Because you're gonna go against E-Myth, and if you win that game, you're gonna go against the winner of the game tomorrow, which Jason will host and cast.
Track and I.
Yeah. So, do you have any final words for E-Myth or whoever next?
I mean, I'm coming for you. I don't know.
There it is. Yeah.
What would final words be?
The harshest Google trash talk.
Yes.
I'll play you, the next time I'm playing Hearthstone.
Yeah.
Right, exactly.
It's really harsh. Like, you can feel the WWF in there. Like, I'm coming for you and I'm sorry.
Yeah. E-Myth. What is E-Myth playing?
Oh, yeah. It's Mohamed Rifat. I totally forgot about that. He's the organizer of the tournament.
Oh, excellent.
Yeah. I just
want
to point out
that the final four then.
Yeah. Well, maybe the odds were tuned. I don't know. Nobody knows.
He did it himself well.
Yeah.
I noticed that in the last match he played, he also played Paladin Mage Warlock. So maybe that is just the set of things everyone's going to be playing now.
So let me ask you, because obviously you know by now that you both had picked the same classes and more or less the same decks, like more or less. Mm-hmm.
Both Freeze Mages, both Secret Paladins.
Yeah. Right. So what were your thoughts? Why did you pick these three classes?
So for me, Paladin is just one of the best classes. It's really strong. You know, if the opponent slips, he dies. So I think that's a good one to play. I really like Reno Warlock. Again, because it's a very strong deck, but also because people routinely, even good players, make mistakes against it if they haven't played against it a ton of times, because you know, it's very hard to know what your opponent's life total is.
Yeah. It's just so demoralizing when it just jumps back up to 30. You're like, right, exactly. All my work.
And up until now, I've been playing a kind of dragon paladin, or a dragon priest, rather, for most of the tournament. But I looked at my matches with Alex before, and then realized that Freeze Mage is good against kind of everything that he played last time, and that he might be, you know, seemed likely to me to be playing this time. So I felt like Freeze Maze was just a good kind of choice against his likely set of decks.
Cool. Yeah, that all makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, thank you, Dave. Thank you, Jason. Thank you, everyone who watched.
Thanks for having me. Congratulations, Dave.
All right. Thanks much. Congratulations. And I guess I'll see you guys next match.
Yeah, probably this week, I guess.
Right.
All right. Have a good night, everybody.
Bye, guys.
Cheers.
I'm going to cut the stream right now. Bye.